until it's a dim down and hush. Cause I can into things that I'm gonna do. Wow, wow, wow. Wow, 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 thoughts. Wow, wow, wow. When I'm with you, all I get is wild thoughts. Wow, wow, wow. When I'm with you, all I get is wild thoughts.
K Bryson. Okay. Really?
You talking to me like your new babe. You talking like you trying to do things. Now that party got her running like she Usain, baby. You made me drown in it, ooh, touche, baby. I'm carrying that water, Bobby Boucher, baby. And you know I'ma slaughter like I'm Jason. Uh-huh. Uh-huh. That's why you got it on safety.
Okay.
Wireless cage you slow. Ready to hate ya. All in this light, I can't
hear you. Now I'm used to stairs and I'm used to... I forgot what I'm supposed to be doing. All right, guys, I hope you like the 15 minute intro. Let's get to the story. Oh, hey, welcome back to my channel. It's PrisellaAfia here. Sorry that I didn't upload last week, guys. I got a bit carried away with my weekend. But today I am back with a story time for y'all about the time that I was paralyzed. And that is the damn truth. I was completely paralyzed. I could not move, could not talk. So let's jump straight into it. But before I get started, guys, don't forget to click the like button below, subscribe to this channel, and leave a comment if you'd like to. Okay. Okay, guys, so this happened a few years ago. I was sleeping, and what happened was I actually went up to try to go to the toilet. And all of a sudden, I actually felt that I couldn't get up. And when I say I couldn't get up, I actually felt that someone was, or something was holding me down to the point where I would try to move my head up, and I actually just, I couldn't get up at all. Like, I can't even explain it. It was just, I was paralyzed. I couldn't get up, and I still really needed to pee. And I'm just like, okay, I don't know what's happening to my body. I thought I was going through shock or something. And I kept trying to get up, and I was starting to stress out, and I was like crying. And when I was crying, I still couldn't move. I was just tears falling down my face. And I was just lying there like, after a few moments, I could start feeling my legs move a bit more, and then all of a sudden I could get up. And I was just like, what the hell was that? I had no idea what the hell was wrong. And this happened a few times when I would fall asleep. I would wake up needing to go to the toilet and I actually couldn't get up. And I didn't understand what was wrong. There's one time that I won't forget where I actually tried to get up to go to the toilet and I felt something pushing me down onto my bed. And I felt something on the side of my face and it was growling into my ear. And I was just like, yeah, the devil is here with me. The devil is about to take control over my body. And I surrender my life to God because I had no idea what was going on and I started freaking out. And because this was actually the third time it happened to me, I knew what was happening and I knew that after a few minutes, my body would get back to its movement. So when this was happening, I just laid there. Not that I really had a choice, but I didn't do anything. I just laid there. After this time, I actually went and told my dad and I explained to him what happened. I didn't understand what was going on. And, you know, Christian family, they told me, or my parents told me to pray about it because it was a evil spirit in my room, which I believed because the sound that was growling in my ear felt like it was an evil entity next to me or on top of me. And I didn't think about it for a couple of years. And then just recently, I don't know if it's becoming more known or it's happening to a lot of more people. It came out that this is called sleep paralysis, and it's explained as a spirit or evil entity that comes into your room or comes over your body and tries to really do anything. And I've watched two documentaries that I will leave at the bottom of my description box, where there's actually people who have been experiencing this pretty much their whole life. And there was two people that I remember. There was one person where he actually felt the spirit was in him and he would do things and he wouldn't remember when he woke up, but there was a recording where you would see him trying to break down doors and to the point where he actually broke his wife's nose. Oh my! And he didn't remember anything, and I was just like, oh my god, thank god I didn't do anything. Or, well, not that I remember that I did anything, but I've experienced this a few times. But there's people out there who's living with this every single day. And there was another guy where they were recording him and his leg just randomly moved and he felt that this entity got on top of him and actually sexually assaulted him. And I'm just like, oh my god. And then I started to think back, oh my god, like, was I possessed? Like, did the evil spirit come into my body? And then I was thinking, oh, maybe I was possessed, because for a couple of years I did some questionable things that I will not share with you, okay? But thank god that was the few times that it happened to me. I sometimes try not to think about it when I go to sleep because I'm scared that this spirit's gonna come back into my room and do whatever it did again. I've been doing a bit of research as well, trying to understand what's the research behind this. Some people think that it's like a mental issue. Some people think, you know, it's actually an evil spirit coming into your room trying to possess your body. And it's a very scary process, and I'm just happy that I haven't experienced it since I was in high school. And I'm hoping that me talking about it now doesn't want the evil spirit to come and be like, okay, let's say hello again, because I don't want you to come back in my life, okay? Thank you. So that is my experience of being paralyzed or sleep paralysis. I haven't actually met anyone who's also experienced this before, so when I have explained this or shared my experience with people, they're just like, oh my god, that's so scary. But if anyone has experienced this before, leave a comment down below so I feel like I'm not the only one that has experiences or felt like I've been possessed before. But yeah, okay, that's my story time for y'all. Don't forget to like, subscribe, leave a comment if you like to. Also, if any of my subscribers have any suggestions of what other videos they'd like to see from moi, please leave a comment down below or send me a message and I'll see what I can do. Okay, see you soon, guys. It's PrisellaAfia here. Sorry that I didn't upload last week, guys. I got a bit carried away. Oh my god. How can I speak? Do you think it's my lips? I don't know.